Alright, hi guys, welcome back to the stream. Today we are going to be doing our magic only run of J.Cocoon. So as always, I'm just going to jump straight into the run. And then I'll explain the rules as we start going through that long intro phase. So the magic only run is that we're only allowed to use magic attacks on our minions. We can't use their regular attacks. We can use Levant's regular attack. And nothing is banned in terms of what Levant can do, but our minions can only use magic. So I spent quite a lot of time last night after the last stream, just before going to bed, working out what earth I should actually do to be able to complete this run. So I was poring over the what minions we have available, what the base stats of bosses are, and all that kind of stuff to work out a potentially viable route. I think I've worked out something that's fairly simple. But we are going to be playing it safe where we're going to have we're always going to use three minions every time. We wouldn't necessarily need three minions at certain points, by my reckoning, but I would rather have three in case I'm wrong. So we are going to lose a little bit of time just to the fact that we're going to be picking up quite a lot of minions. So, the problem with magic minions is they have very low health and very low defense.
Rickets has run away.
Still uninterrupted.
He's run off, it's all hearsay. It seems his body was stolen by a naughty woman, and he ran off, His son is still so young. Too young to become a kaboom master. Run away, will you?
So the more magical your minion becomes, the more mana it gets, which helps you cast more spells, but it comes at the cost of HP. And typically, if you want magic, that often comes with magic and speed rather than magic and defense. We are going to use one minion that has pretty good defense, but I'd actually rather the speed, if I'm honest. So we aren't going to be capturing too many minions early on, but one of the key minions we need to capture is the Shulia in the Moth Forest, and we're going to need to capture six of them, unfortunately. But we have a limited number of captures at that stage in the game. That's after our village has been turned to stone, but before we make it to the Temple of Kemuel. And obviously during that time we can't merge new minions, we can't equip new minions or anything like that, we're stuck with whatever we have. To my knowledge. So we only get one set of tries to capture those Shulias. We have 12 attempts total. That's how many minions you can capture before returning back to get them purified. And we need to succeed six times. If we don't, we might have a bit of problems. Sorry, a bit of trouble. We will have problems, and it will cause us a bit of trouble. But yeah, I wanted to not ban Levant's regular attack for the purpose of capturing minions. Otherwise, you're just, you know, at the start of the game, you're just mashing capture until you luck out, which is a bit dull, and I would have to be mashing defend here, which would make this fight take forever. Well, not so much the minion fight, but when we had to fight the Ptaimal in the second dream, that would take absolutely ages for that Ptaimal to kill us. So yeah, we're allowed to use the Lance abilities. We are allowed seals as well. They are magic. I normally ban seals, but we're not in this run because they are magic. In fact, most of the time I ban seals just because I think they will detract from the run, which I don't think is really the case in this one. I know you can beat Kikinak with Ptaimals. It would be pretty dull for me to just grab some Ptaimals, level them up enough, and kill Kikinak that way, than to just use seals to get past him. Yeah, so our initial minions, we're actually going to switch out what minions we're going to be using at different parts of the run. We're essentially going to have our starter minions, which we use to get to the Temple of Kemuel. The only boss they have to fight is Poacher. That's the only thing we have to kill and capture those Shillias. So they will need to be leveled up and used a fair bit just to get that out of the way. Then we're going to switch to a team of Ids to take down Taurus. Reason why is just because there is no other access to water tier 2 magic until that point. And we'd have to capture way more minions earlier on if we wanted to use a different base minion. So I think we're going to be fine if we just use 3 Ids. They will need to be pretty heavily leveled though. We're then going to switch to Hirasag and Amasag based minions. Preferably Hirasag. Amasag has higher magic attack as a base, but Hirasag has the plus 10% magic damage traits. But our minions are going to be merged a fair bit in this run. Not as much as the non-elemental run by a long shot, but there's going to be quite a bit more diversity of minion that you see during this run. Which I think is a nice change of pace, because our last... Well, the 80% runs are always the same two minions. Petimal run... Oh, sorry, only run was of course just Petimals. And we used the same minion bases throughout for the non-elemental run. And we're going to be changing that up. Partly that's due to the fact that it's just going to take forever for us to modify our minions' elements to where we want them to be. But also that I think, with regards to magic damage, the later minions are actually just better. Ids, I think, are worse than Fowls and Ashes and Shillias, I should say. But unfortunately, they can't have water attack until you merge them with a bunch of Ids, and that kind of ruins their stat line anyway. I think the only vanilla minion we're going to end up with is a vanilla Amasag, which we're probably going to merge with a bunch more Amasags to buff its magic a bit further. I'm a bit concerned that that is going to come at the cost of health, so we're going to have barely any health on any of our minions by the end of this. Like, the Petimal's 400 was pretty bad. 400 would be pretty good. In fact, it would be amazing to have that kind of HP on magic minions. Yeah, so we're going to open up by capturing some Squasps. They're the earliest minion we can capture that's going to have air magic, which is what we want to take down Gigoat. We will also have to spend some time capturing minions in the Spider Forest. Not to use, but purely for the fact that we need a decent capture level so that we can capture those Shillias. Just to get that first one.
According to tradition, I hereby proclaim your coming of age. Your bride from this day forward, treacherous.
Yes, thankfully Gigoat actually has less physical defense than magic defense. Sorry, less less magic defense than physical defense, so it may be a bit easier than I was anticipating. And the elemental bosses themselves all have low, low magical defense. But our problem's going to be getting the blocks we need for our minions to not die. That's going to be what we're afraid of. I also am a bit concerned that Ids are incredibly slow, so Taurus may get double turns on them. They have decent physical defense, so they're not actually that bad when we get poison attack, but yeah, taking extra turns from Taurus is not really what we want to be seeing on our minions. I may want to hold on to the Tendai that we get in the Moth Forest. Purely for the purpose of reviving an Id. Taurus is probably the hardest fight in this run. That is my naive reckoning, because I haven't I've never done this before or anything really like it with regards to using magic. So I'm somewhat speculating just based on what I know of the minions and the stat lines of the bosses. Also, weirdly, Ids and. Well, Ids are the nominate species. They don't have increased magic attack damage, despite being flyers. Which is a bit strange. Most of the others do. Yeah, we actually may get in trouble with the Ids if we get a lot of fire magical attack from Totoro, really, because Ids have very low magic, they're very low magic defense in relation to their physical. We will have elemental advantage, so we might be alright. But that won't be too entertaining of a, or creative, I suppose, of a thing to do, since Ids are what you use when you get stuck. Like, if you ever played this game casually, and you got stuck in the Dark Beetle Forest, for whatever reason, Ids are the only water elemental minion, other than Squimmels, which, to be fair, a bunch of Squimmels absolutely can take down Totoro. They're one of your only two options to take down Totoro, and I think it's the most obvious one to go for is to get a bunch of Ids. But that's like assuming you merged Arpatron away into some other minion, and you just didn't build a strong water minion at any point. That's how you recover it, you get Ids. Unfortunately, they're level 11 though, because it'll take a bit of time to get them to the right level. I don't know what level you'd need for Ids to take down Totoro. I want to say 13, 14, which is pretty standard. Probably more on the 14 side than 13. Granted, I'll only have one Devas Mirror, so. An element of that is going to be working out whether or not I want to risk it, or if I just run into Totoro and give it a go. Yeah, I wasn't sure if it was Id or Swav that was the nominate species for that minion, but I found out when I was looking it up that they didn't have the magic attack buff anyway, so it doesn't really matter. I think Swavs have higher magic attack, but have lower physical defense. So, in theory, you could capture a Swav, then, or sorry, three Swavs, and then nine Ids. If you want to be that masochistic about it, and you'll end up with slightly more magic attack that way, but I do not think it's worth doing that. We're not going to capture Arpatron. We have no use of Arpatron. Arpatron's magic attack is not good. The only reason to capture Arpatron would be to give our Ids access to. Would sorry, would be to give them access to. Actually, no, we'll capture one because I'm kind of curious. It'll give our Ids access to Barley, but we're only going to capture one. I'm not going to bother with the whole capturing three Arpatrons, which I could do. So they were all like that, but I don't think it's worth doing. Depending on the total mana we end up with our Ids, Barley may be useful, like a little bit. But what I'm expecting us to do is to use Valia like twice and then switch to the next Swav, use Valia twice, switch to the next Swav. That's what I'm expecting us. Sorry, but next Id. That's what I'm expecting us to do. But we'll merge one with an Arpatron, and then like another two Ids or something to correct for the stat changes that merging one with an Arbitron will do. I may just hold on to the Arbitron forever, to be honest. I may just have an Arbitron and not use it. Ah, cheers, dude. Yeah, hopefully this will go alright. I'm just gonna see if I can dodge this thing just... Yeah, okay, I can. may as well get some any percent practice in while I'm out. While I'm out doing a different kind of run. So we want... If we want to be safe, we want to pick up three... Squasps. And that'd be the safe thing to do. So this will be Squasp number one. So, we're not actually capturing Squasps for their stats. They have a better magic stat than Arbitron, but we don't want to actually use Squasps. But we want to use McShearers from the Dragonfly Forest, but they don't have any offensive magic. So we're capturing these Squasps to merge with the McShearers in order to give them magic attacks. For some reason, they decided to give them the Maxure a good magic attack as a base, and then no magic attacks. I think they gave them the air ones have sleep. Oh, we're doing a bit too much damage to the Squasp. I may have to just. They have slightly worse defense than Potimal, so they're actually kind of awkward to capture. We'll see if this one will just go immediately. I'd appreciate it if it would. I mean, I believe the Max Shearers will capture will be level 4 by default. I think that's Wasps. Oh no. Yeah, it didn't get out. Cool. Max Shearers, I think you capture at level 4. And capturing these Squasps will get us to capture level 3 as well. We're gonna have to respawn the Squasps. So we're going to have to do a pair of transitions here, at least. And hopefully, if the game is kind to us, it'll have given us a Squasp again. There we go. I said, I don't know if we actually need 3 minutes. Squasps blocking Levan. I don't know if we need three Squasps to take down Gigoat. I think realistically we probably don't. But we also must use magic to take down Poacher. And a very notable difference between using physical attacks and magic attacks is that physical attacks have that 1.2 times damage bonus, whereas these basic magic attacks do not. They do 1 times damage. So that's 20% of our damage out the window just because we're using magic. Oh, this Squasp looks like it might get out. But I'm aware that if I hit it, it may just die. So we'll try again. Get in the cocoon, Squasp. Looks good. Okay, cool. And now that we've done that, we can wrong warp out of here. Provided I don't mess up the wrong warp. We're done with the Beetle Forest. There is nothing more for us here. That might be a little bit early. There we go. Yeah, so all we want to do in the next forest is capture 3 Maxuras, then defeat Geekynak. Slight difficulty though. I believe you fight Maxuras in pairs. And while they don't have very high attack, to say the least, there are 2 of them. And our Squasps are not really up to the challenge. So we are going to purify and equip them here. The other problem is they have no good fights. Squasp, unfortunately, as a minion, has no good fights in the early game. So what I may want to do, actually, is bring Arpatron. Because the only point of these Squasps is to be merged away. So we don't need to level them up, really. Or rather, if we can avoid leveling up them up, we will. So what we're going to do... we'll buy... Actually, no, I'll spend all my money on it, so it's fine. We shall level up Arpatron to give them a better shot. We'll actually go into the Beetle Forest, you know. We'll fight some Patashes, get Arpatron to level 3. The only notable good fight I can think of for the Squasps is the Tortoises. But I think the amount of damage we take from... Oh, that time had moved further forward than I had expected. Yeah, the problem we'll have... Also, we have to use Vali on our Arpatron, which is very sad. This will be a good demonstration of the key issue. We only have enough mana to use Vali twice. Once our minion is out of mana, we can't really do anything. So now the Patimal's at 3 health. Even though it's at 3 health, we now need to block until we get enough mana to use Vali a third time. Which is going to take 3 blocks. Is this worth it? I don't know. But I think a level 2 Arpatron's going to be helpful. Either way. Alright. Demo 4. Let's go to the Dragonfly Forest. We may have to do a lot of running away from minions just to regenerate our mana. That's the other major downside to this run. Your minions recover a quarter of their mana per fight. Which isn't an issue when you have strong, high damage physical attacks as much, but when you have only magic, and magic just plainly isn't strong, it doesn't work out so well for you. So I'm pretty sure this Mardreg is actually too difficult for us to kill with our two squasps. So we're gonna run away. I'd probably punch it in the face with Levant to get it weak enough, then finish it off with the squasp to get a squasp to level 3. Feels a little bit cheeky to do that. That seems to be a Mardreg, so we'll stand here, then go around. We may do that to a Toad, to be honest, though. We may be cheeky on a Toad and get Levant low. So use Levant to get it low. And then finish it off with a Squasp, just so we have a Squasp that's not terrible. Is this a Toad by itself? Attack it from the rear. It's two of them. And a level 4. So, let's just see what this will be like. These guys are very slow, which is good. But they do a lot of damage. So I guess we're going to get one of them low. Heal Levant up. Finish that one with the Squasp. I say get it low, I don't actually know if we can do that, it's actually... No. Put all enemies. Actually does a fair bit of damage. Not sure about this plan. I was kind of hoping for just one. If it was one by itself, I think we had a decent shot at it. Or if Levant, like, blocked these attacks, I'd appreciate it. You can actually see when Levant is about to block one. It's kind of funny. Right, I think that's all we're getting out of Levant. We could Metamuggle again. I did buy the extra specifically for this purpose. We only actually need to take down one of these. Yeah, this would be another reason why I said we should allow Levant to attack. Otherwise we'll be trapped very early on with magic minions that can't really kill anything. Unless we take a very long roundabout route involving capturing a lot of minions. Right. That should be low enough that a Squasp can finish it off. I think I'll do one more attack onto it, and then I don't want to take any chances. There's also the risk that I don't want to risk Levant. How many turns am I getting here? I'm waiting for the what is going on? Does defend use up, like, give you a better speed? That Ryu has not attacked in a long time. There you go, thank you. Other one? Okay, that's what I wanted. This is just so to make sure that we don't get double attacked on... Oh, sorry, we don't get attacked on our Squasp when we switch it in. Alright, Rig, you down? We're just gonna switch back to Levan and we're gonna run. That's all that's gonna happen. We can use that same Squasp to take down another Rigu after this. Oh, that took a while, didn't it? There we go. Level 4 Squasp. Much better. Much, much, much better. There's another one. Another two, sorry. So how's the Squasp fare now? Use magic so rarely that I'm very much so doing this on the fly. Yeah, that should be fine for us to take down with our other Squasp. So I'm going to use one more spell on that Rigu. We did 48 to it with two attacks, so if I can count. So it should live this on 4. 5 is fine as well. That's going to do a fair bit of damage. Ooh, that Squasp might die. Never mind, it wanted to live. It knew what it wanted. Man, this challenge will be so easy to mess up, because as soon as I use an attack, like just autopilot an attack, runs dead. I suppose we'll set the rule that if I use a regular attack, I have to intentionally die. Or lose. If it's like a boss fight, I have to lose. That's probably the easiest way so that we don't have to waste additional hours starting from the beginning again. Anyway. We can't use that last Metamuggle, but we actually need that one to take down Kikinek. Okay, so it's time to take down some Akshiras, which I believe we have to fight in pairs. If they're the wrong element, I can easily switch them. The room after their room transitions the elements. Yes, these are the wrong element. We fight them in pairs. We do. Ooh, oh no, this correct element. I was looking at the inside of the wings. I thought was wrong. I did not realize they were level 5. That's a bit higher than I was anticipating. We'll run from this pair so we get mana back on our. Okay, never mind. You see, they don't do very much damage at all. That'd be on account. Okay. Not wanting me to. Oh, there we go. There's their only magic. It's put us to sleep. And that's the part that's concerning about taking down these Mashiras. I thought they were level 4, but I guess they're level 5. Hmm. How close are you? Need to think now, that's actually kind of tricky now. The mana is our problem, we only get 3 attacks. And finally, just a single Riku. What do I want? I want... I suppose I want level 5 Squasps, right? On one. I guess this Squasp is getting a level. Maybe I should change plan and just use Squasps to take down Gigoat. Those Max Shuras are going to be awkward to capture. Oh, that's not a comfortable capture. So this way, there's a... I knew there was another one. Oh wait, I don't think I have enough mana to kill it. I can regenerate it. Shuras also have pretty good magic defense, is the other annoyance. Like to do realistically is defeat one Max Shura outright, just have it die, and then capture the other. But that does require us to actually successfully kill a Max Shura, which is actually pretty difficult for us to do. Without elemental advantage, it's the same as using regular attacks to defeat it, except it takes reduced damage because it's got higher magic defense, and the fact that we only have 3 attacks before we have to use a different minion. Okay, I'll tell you what, I have a plan. We're going to go straight to the spider forest. We're going to kill things there to get our squass much stronger, then come back and get the Max Shuras. That makes sense to me. I think we're too far back. Here we were. I think that's the only way we can... I say easily, that's the... probably the only reliable way we can get Max Shuras. but I would like them. They have slightly lower speed than Squimmels. Sorry, than Squasps. But they have much more magic damage. Time Elves have bit. I forgot that we hadn't killed that guy. Yeah, they have base 150 magic attack to the Squaffs 120. Capture level increases your odds of capturing higher level minions. If you are at a significant capture level deficit, then you're going to struggle to capture minions that are higher level than you. Generally speaking, as a rule, you can capture a minion that's in red if it's like 2 capture levels above you, but more than that, and you're sort of Hail Marying it. You're sort of just hoping at that point. I think the largest level difference I've ever successfully caught a minion was about 7 levels. It's obviously, I think it's possible to do it any time. Like, I'm sure it's possible to do, like, I'm sure you capture like a level 30 with a level 1. Not that you can encounter level 30s, but say you could. With capture level 1, I just think it's very unlikely. I think the math says it's possible. Yeah, we don't gain HP or anything like that on Levant through capturing. You have to use Great Walnuts to get additional HP. So close now that I don't trust it. Oh yeah, like, I wouldn't want to try. Like, you've got 12 attempts, you're probably going to fail every single attempt with that kind of disparity. This is why I want to capture something in the Spider Forest to get us up, to have better odds at capturing the Shulius, because we have those 12 attempts and we need to succeed. I don't think it's right. Oh, it was. Should have trusted my first instinct. This is where I shouldn't have trusted my first instinct, because that doesn't actually look right. Dragonfly Forest, why you do this to me? Well, I hope we aren't here for another hour. That'd be nice. How much, I saved 1 mugwort for the express purpose of healing in case we fail to escape from more encounters. Yeah, we're capture level 3, so the Maxurers actually aren't that bad in terms of odds once they're weak. But we need to get them weak. To be fair, another option is to get our capture level very high from Spider Forest minions and then just try to capture them outright. If you're at an advantage with capture levels, you can capture minions like instantly. Without needing to weaken them at all. Don't trust where I've stood. Yeah, there it is. We'll get it eventually. Take this because why not? Don't care about saving. We'll make sure it's a level 5. So you don't have the worst odds at capture level 7. So you wouldn't actually need to capture. I forgot to sell Valerian powder, I almost always remember to sell that. Anyway, let's kill Kikinak. We just can't clear the spider forest until we have the Makshiras. Because if we do that, we then... Run is probably dead, actually, if we do that. What am I going to summon? I don't need to summon anything. Yeah, Run probably dies if I clear the spider forest on autopilot. Yeah, I'd say like 7 or 8. And we'd be able to capture a Makshira. The problem is that we're then having to capture a level 6 minion, a level 3, which is a bit tricky. 6 or 7. So, also if Kikinak crits us, then we have to go this long way. So realistically, I would like to just capture a Makshira with Levan. We will be capturing minions in the Spider Forest anyway, and there are none there that we actually want. So I may just get our Squasps to like level 6 or 7. Try and capture a few things. Then come back to get the Makshiras. Either way, we were gonna have to fight things with our Squasps anyway. Oh, no Grey Walnut. That's a bit sad. I think I will speak to Mabu just because I do want to fight minions in the Spider Forest. And we'll pick up our other Squasp. Because why not? I don't think we needed to bother with Arbitron. But this route isn't meticulously planned. Or as simple as... Batimel only was a very simple plan. Get Batimel. Fight with Batimel. Win game. Ah. Because we spoke to Mabu here... That was some weird animation freaky stuff. Because we spoke to Mabu here, she's going to cause us to go into a dialogue that we don't care about. I think you can get an item if you do speak to her. But I'm just going to leave her. Only absolute heartless wretch. And I'm just going to leave instantly. Don't normally see that because we don't talk to Mabu at all. Until post-Spider Forest normally. That dialogue only happens if you speak to her before you finish the Spider Forest. Yes, so there should be a Turgor here. If it's currently blue, we'll make it green. Yeah, it's a blue. So we're gonna go make it green. And we're gonna kill it with some Ptymals. Well, we speak to her involuntarily, but I don't think that quite qualifies. We didn't choose to talk to her at that point. But yes, I suppose we speak to Mabu until we marry her, and then we stop talking to her. I don't know what kind of commentary that says on the notion of marriage, but I'm sure it's not good. Yes, this Rogue Doggle. In the Eternal Corridor, it will be a Tegor instead. They're easy kills for our. Should we see if we can kill it with a level 1? That'd be kind of cool. I don't like my odds. But it's worth a shot, isn't it? Okay, maybe I should have had more faithful in that. They don't have best magic defense. There we go, we have a level 7 squad. I think these guys are level 6. No, they're also level 7. Okay, that's cool. So we'll have a squasp take down a level 7 each. I'm just using this one to optimize the process. And then level 7 squasps should quite comfortably take down Max Shearers. Should be another. Oh, a weapon. We will not pick it up. I haven't gone through the regular spider forest at this point for so long. But I have no idea where any of the chests are or anything like that. I know where one of the keys is. But I have completely forgotten the layout of. In terms of items and stuff, of regular. Spider Forest. Okay, so we're going to defeat this with our last level 5 Squasp. Then we're going to try and capture one of these. I don't know if Levant's up to it. There's a sizable level difference in terms of capture level. A very big difference. But if it succeeds, then the Muxuras will be way easier to capture. There we go. That should respawn one of the enemies. Actually, to be fair, I should have switched elements as well. Never mind. Oh, no, it's that screen. It's the other screen in front of me on my right that switches elements, not this one. Alright, let's see if we can do it. We are 4 capture levels under. Our minions are going to be absolute abominations, by the way. I don't know if you've ever seen a Mechsha emerge with a squash, but it is not pretty. So I think we'll hit it once with Levant. Just because we are permitted to, and I would like to increase my odds given the terrible level disparity. Okay, one more. Okay, this is the best odds I could possibly realistically give myself. Capture this minion. We don't have any healing items, so if we die, we die. In which case, we'll heal up Amabu and we'll just go straight to the Mechsha's. Oh, it looks so good. Why do you do that to me? Okay, right, time to die. I don't think we're gonna get this, to be honest. I was gonna be like, are you serious? When it looked like we're about to capture it, but I don't like our odds. It might just do the exact same thing again. Okay, cool. Good. Good, capture level 7 for us. We're still gonna have to talk to Marvu to go heal ourselves. But we do not care at all about the minion we've just captured. It is of literally no value to us. Okay, so heal up. Get Mechsha's. Fuse those into fuse optimals into them. Capture maybe like one more. And then into the Moth Forest we go. Where we must capture 6 Shulias. I cannot stress how bad it will be for us if we don't manage to capture 6 Shulias. I may actually save in the event that we fail. Like, before we go in, I may fail just to improve our odds. And by improve our odds, I mean if we fail, I try again. We should be capture level 8, Shulia's level 10. Shouldn't be too bad. We'll use our seal items to get there. Because that gets them down to about 7 or 8. And we'll do that just to guarantee the first one. Our minions should be strong enough to take down Shulias. It's still correct, so we should just be able to run straight in. Alright, let's get ourselves some Mechsha's. Bit of a long run to get into a fight with them, but that is what it is. Mechsha's. Squasp. So, I don't know if we get them both weak, capture both of them, or we get one weak, kill one, and capture the other. Do 21 damage. Oh, we are asleep. Sleep is so strong in this game. Of the three ailments of flesh to stone poison sleep, I think sleep is objectively the best one. The only minions that the only wild minions that are naturally resistant to it are very weak defensively. Which makes them very easy kills in the Eternal Corridor, whereas there are quite a few minions that are actually fairly resistant to flesh to stone. There are more minions that are resistant to flesh to stone than sleep, and also you don't get any XP if you flesh to stone a minion. I think you just get a lot more out of it if you use sleep instead. Poison's arguably similarly good, as long as you don't, as long as a minion doesn't die to poison. But I think the extra turns you get from sleep and the increased damage on the next physical hit from sleep just trumps that by a mile. Alright, since we have two capture levels advantage, we shouldn't have to weaken them all the way. Okay, cool. That's one. So you just need three of these. Our minions will have less health than they did before. But they will have a fair bit more magic attack, and they will have the hidden buff to their magic. For all I know, this is all unnecessary, and we could just use squasps. And by for all I know, almost certainly we could just use squasps. The only thing that's necessary about this probably is the capture of the... That'll be a wrong element now. We'll, be the Shulias. That's the only absolutely necessary part. For all we know, these minions may come back into it later. I don't know if they will. I mean, maybe we merge them onto our, maybe we merge them onto our final air minions. That's an option. Then we could theoretically capture fewer Shulias, but I'd rather have at least six, really. I'd like to have the best odds I can. I have to say, this is the first time while playing this game that I've ever struggled against a Max Shearer. Obviously not right now, but in this run. where capturing Amakshira has been a problem that has to be solved. Okay. Now we just need to go back to the Spider Forest. We have our three Makshuras. Capture any minion that I don't care about. Probably a Tergal. Warp to the end. Do our mergers when we speak to Mabu. Can't hit it with Levant this time. It'll take too much damage. Probably. It is a bit weird capturing minions purely for the purpose of increasing my capture level. Not because we actually want them. We haven't had to do that in any of our other runs. We don't technically have to here, I'm just choosing to because I want to give us better odds. Alright. Get this wrong warp now. Early. Nope, never mind. Don't know if that's right. It is a bit painful what the difference between right and wrong is for these wrong warps. No, I've come to try again. So early. Yeah. This run has not been good for the wrong warps, Jesus. At least we aren't doing it 80%. Walking will make it easier. Okay. I know I should try doing it while walking. So I have no idea. I think that's still wrong though. Never mind. Maybe it's easier to do one. Maybe I should walk in future. Not for the sake of, like, timing the setup. Maybe I should, though. Oh, that was a... Sorry, that was a very weird dodge on my butt. That was not... I've never been hit by the snake before. That was a very wonky dodge. Yeah, maybe in the next any percent runs, I'll walk up to it instead. Probably not on the beetle one, because I don't think I need to. But maybe for the dragonfly and for this one, it'll be more consistent if I walk. Find out later. I'll try it again on the second part of this. See if that is just outright easier. Doing it the whole time running, so here it gives me a slightly better well, slightly easier to read the visual clues. I have more time to react to the visual clue, so maybe that would be wise. I think I'm more likely to do it slightly, well, maybe not, I'm more, not maybe not more likely to do it slightly either. Depends on what kind of visual clue I'm looking for. My left headphone is getting pretty beat up these days, unfortunately. Still works, still fine, but it's a bit wonky. Right, now we mustn't forget to merge our actuaries into our squasps, or the other way around, rather. This is also going to be a bit of a test to see if these lower defense, higher damage output minions are going to be worth using later on. Spin the rug, the Rugdougals, because we don't bother to. The Rugdougal? I think so. Because we don't need them. So, Max Shura. So, you see, that's two more. Two. No, three more magic attacks this way. So, that's what the plan is. So we are sacrificing health in exchange for a bit more mana. Not that the extra mana matters right now, but more importantly, much better output in terms of damage. So we're done with that. We no longer have squasps, we have Ashgiras, and we will spin. Keep after on. Spin these Rugdougals. Alright, remember to do that. Jobs are good. I'm going to apologize in advance for what these minions are going to look like. They're gonna look really weird. was the radius of that spell? I assume it just affects our village, but I don't know if it's meant to have affected everyone. I'm pretty sure it just affects the village, but it's not really that well explained in terms of radius effect. Like, if I visited the village, would I have been affected? Is it targeted? Or is it not? Is it just AoE? And if so, how big? Could you imagine how big of a mistake it would have been if we forgot to equip the, after merging, we just forgot to equip the Meshkiras. And we had no minions now to do the Moth Forest with. Yeah, our best bet is to... Normally you use seals to get your minion, one of your minions up to... Sorry, your seals to get one of your minions up to level 10. But I think, because we have wind minions, which aren't a terrible level, that we instead capture... Use that to capture a Shulia, since we need six of them. And we use the... The strong guys, the chews in the Moth Forest to level up our minions. I can't remember if they're level 9 or 10, but with 3 wind minions, I'd be very surprised if we couldn't take them down. Snakes were red, which means this is the correct element. I must remember to put on the Rickett's Garb after I pick up this liquor. I will not use equip. Very important that I do that. So we want a whole bunch of these. We're just using Levant to help us capture the first one. For the ones after this, we're just going to use our minions to weaken them, switch to Levant, and then capture them. But I figured this was our most reliable shot at getting them low health, since we don't know what kind of health they'll have after our minions use their magic on them, and since we can't use our minions' regular attacks, it's harder to gauge whether or not we'd be able to... Well, we'd have less control over how much health is left on the Shulia, so we wouldn't know if we'd be able to capture it that way as easily. So that is one of six. We're going to fight the guys in here, who should be water right now. Let's grab this. Okay, I think we're gonna do some... Oh, that hit me from behind. Well, I didn't expect that to happen, so I think we're dead. Which, to be fair, means we'll get a free heal. I got two turns. Yeah, okay, we are dead. You can't dodge magic. I did not realize that that actually catches you. If you do that. Bobby will heal us. Yes, very good, Mabu. So that's what happens if you die in the North Forest. Mabu heals you up. You go back in. So, it's going to be an Asher now. It's a bit of an issue. In fact, I'm going to use the sleep spores because I don't want to fight an Asher. I want to fight... the... punching guys in the next room. With our horrific looking, Maxurias. These guys are like, yeah, they're also level 10, so that's good. So let's see how bad they look. Better than I'd expected, but it's still pretty cursed. It's using flesh to stone on us. Oh, sorry, poison, rather. Which, honestly, is fine. Poison doesn't do a whole lot to us. Given that it's percentage-based damage. And we don't have a lot of health anyway. That's what we don't like. Any actual attack that hits us is very scary. I believe if you switch to a non-poison minion, it just tries to poison you again. Oh, it lived on one? Okay, no, it just poisons the first minion. One thing we don't have to worry about because we're using magic is we can't miss. We can't critical hit either, but we can't miss. So our damage is very consistent. There we go. That's one level 10. There's one in here as well. We'll fight them. Isn't actually too bad. Our defense is terrible. It is actually abysmal, but our health isn't looking too bad. There's the poison. We'll switch to our only fresh Mashgira. Going to take down one more of these. We're just going to use this to respawn it. I don't know which spot they should respawn in if... because I've never actually... well, it's not that I haven't, it's just like don't respawn here normally. I don't really fight these guys ever because you just walk around them. Come on, respawn. Okay, there you go. I think three level 10 wind minions should take down Gigoat and Poacher. That sounds logical to me. Absolutely fine with poison. We We of course are going to need to now use these minions to take down Shulias. Which is a little less nice. But our magic defense is significantly better than our physical. Okay, let's go fight some Shulias. So what we're gonna do, hopefully, we should still be asleep. Never mind, it literally just woke up. How come we got around it that time? Whatever. So we'll switch the element back to wind, which is what we've done by doing that. And let the Shulia capturing begin. So, both of us are magically defensive. So this is going to be kind of painful. Shulias do have a higher magic attack than us, and they're using significantly stronger magic. So we did 71 over 2 attacks. So, yeah. They only have enough mana to do 2 of those. And this Mashkira will regenerate the health that it lost, as well as the mana. Unfortunately, a bit of a dull part of the run. So up to 2. It'll be worth it in the end. It'd be nice if these guys dropped Divine Garb for us. I think it's Divine Garb that they can drop. Yeah, you can really see how much health suffers in exchange for magic power. Because these Shulias, the same levels as they level as us, they have 29 less health. I believe we actually have higher magic defense than them, which is why damage disparity isn't so bad. I think we can get away with 4 Shulias. I don't want to spend too long just capturing the same minion over and over again, so I think we'll only just capture one more, because we have three air minions. Which should be enough to, modify our Hirasag's element to Earth, which is what we want, ultimately. So I think we just capture this last one and then we go. We are, of course, going to have to heal our Mashiras to fight Gigoat. It's going to be a bit embarrassing if we do all this, go fight Gigoat, and find that our minions aren't quite strong enough. But we have 15 attacks before we're out of mana. So I don't think amount of attacks is going to be a problem, it's going to be the health and the complete lack of physical defense on our minions. That's the problem. Gigoat has a neutral attack plus power, which is worse for us than if it had earth attack plus power. Well, actually, no, I think it's worse for us that it's neutral. Earth-type plus power would have a higher base damage, but then we take significantly less because of the elemental advantage. So I think neutral plus power is actually still better for us. Worse for us, rather. Critical hit from a Shilia does 10 damage. Yeah, we're just going to hold on to these Shilias. Not going to do anything special with them for a while. We're literally just going to hold on to them. There we go. Okay then. So the Hat Barons will have reawoken. I'm fine with, to be honest. I'm kind of curious to see if you can indeed use this side to just dodge the Pat Baron. Oh, you nearly can, can't you? Nearly. I think if you juke to the right first, then you'll get it. Approach on the right, moves towards you, and then just run all the way around it. You should be able to get around that. Okay, we only need to heal one Mashira. I don't think it's necessary to heal Levant. So let's just get that. Chab Liquor is good enough, so we'll use that. Right. Now here's the question. Do we attack Poacher or do we just block? I think we just attack. I don't think there's a reason not to. Not good enough reason anyway. So Gigo has not great magic defense. Yes, that's why I thought maybe to block. Because Gigo will get a turn on us, but I don't think that's significant enough. Okay, yeah, we're definitely fine. We are definitely fine. Worried about nothing. We will switch to Mashira number 2. Thank you. Yes, you could do this with two minions. And that'd cut a lot of time off. But we weren't exactly planning on doing this optimally anyway. Wouldn't even bother getting Arcadron if we were trying to do it optimally. yeah, we should win this. With this. Yeah, so like two Mushkiras is enough. There we go. So, next stage in the plan is how do you beat Sturrus? And the answer is with IDs. Our current minions are not going to be any good to us. It'll take way too long to switch their elements to water. And IDs have a higher base magic attack anyway. IDs have no hope of getting a double attack on Taurus though. So three vanilla IDs leveled sufficiently should be fine. Definition of sufficiently is where the debate comes in. I want to say 14. And so Arbitron gets some usage, maybe we merge Arbitron into one. You know, just so Arbitron's actually used in this run at all. If I merged with Arbitron, I'd probably want to capture an additional aid. Actually, that's one thing that's going to be annoying. The id's going to be, it's going to be a swab when I go in. Oh, that's going to be annoying. So I'm going to have to go in, leave immediately, then go back in to make it the right element. I don't really want to fight swabs on account of the fact that our minions are air right now. Unfortunately, those ids are not going to see much action after Tartarus is dead. Those ids no longer matter. You purely want them to sit down to Tartarus. just because the Amasag we can capture in the forest immediately after is instantly going to trump the Ids outright. Much worse defense, but they are so much faster. And they have even higher magic damage output, which we care about. And we only need one anyway. One, two air and one water. I remember as a kid, Ids were my favorite minion. I just loved the fact that it was a three-headed dragon. A shame it's not actually very good as a minion, in terms of stats. Alright, let's go shopping. Forest, out of the forest, back into the forest. Capture the two Ids that start there. Then respawn the Ids. Capture one more, leave forest, switch out every minion that we have equipped. Go back into the forest, and it should be a suave. Blah blah blah, go through forest. Fight Turris with three level 13/14 Ids. The suave. Leave immediately. Go back in. And now it'll be it. difference between the Eternal Corridor equivalent of Spicarsis? Sorry. Maybe Spicarsis do have the effect, then I thought it would be an id. I guess id's what you find in the Eternal Corridor. Spicata is what you find. Yeah. The only difference is, like, a slight blue colour. Like, one's... They're both obviously blue. But they are a very close blue to each other. Oh no, these are actually going to be hard to capture. Two attacks to do. Oh, we can take one more. You see what I mean by they're slow. I don't know how many of those it can do before it's out of mana. In terms of mana efficiency, it's actually better to use Vali than ban the stronger version. In terms of damage to mana, but because our minion's not going to have any health or defense, in the long run we don't really care about that. We just want to get our attacks out. If we went the Valia route, then we wouldn't get sufficient attacks in to actually use all our mana. But I would estimate that it would take 6 Valias to take down Tauros. The problem you have is that you then don't have any mana left to kill Fire Boss. Hence the need for all the healing items. I'm gonna hope this the name's just throwing me off. Strikata? Capture level 12, it's worth a shot to try it. I don't know if I damaged it too much. I forgot about our one level 12 minion. Shot to try again. After it attacks, I'll switch into our one of our other level 10s and try to use them. Yeah, it's getting out again. Yeah, I shouldn't have the mana for anything other than that attack now. I'm pretty sure our magic attack does too much. I don't think I correctly accounted for the fact that we had a level 12. It did a bit too much damage. You know what? I'm not gonna complain. I appreciate the fact that I'm wrong. Being wrong is good sometimes. Get in the cocoon. Cease not being in the cocoon. This is a willful. It's a willful minion. If it got out again, I swear to God, I would have been so annoying. I would have just kept trying, but it would have been. I'd have been annoyed. I wouldn't have been happy about having to do that. Okay, so it's an element transition. We're gonna go back through again. Switch it back to water. And now we need to go capture another one. Hopefully they respawned. They may not have, but hopefully they did. They did. Other ones can really take much of that punishment. It's kind of a lot for them. Got a better shot at living. It says if it matters, if it dies, it doesn't. It doesn't matter if Shkira dies, but I'd like to have a deathless. I can actually defend. I'd like to have a deathless run for our own minions. Just feels nice. Yeah, we should have just skipped capturing Arbitron, not bothered to level them. I thought potentially that Arbitron's tankiness may help us from being tankier at the time than the squash, but it just didn't matter. But we'll have an Arbitron, because why not just have an Arbitron? Right. It's funny that I missed that the Spicata was the nominate species, not the id. Maybe I just expected the name to be shorter because Suave is so short. That is one of those families where every element has a very different name. Every elemental version of the minion has a very different name. It doesn't follow the same convention as all of the other minions. Alright. There's our Shulias. Doing this the slow way. There we go. So these Spricatas have more magic attack than our current minions. So we're going to have them defeat some Suaves, and by some I mean one Suave, because I doubt there'll be two here. Then we'll fight some Squimmels, Fire Squimmels preferably, since they're level 12. That's probably the fastest way to get them to level 14. Patdregs will also do it, they're also level 12. But them coming in pairs can make it a little bit harder for us, since the mana regeneration we get between battles is kind of what we're relying upon. So we want to be at 75 mana. That's 3 Balias per minion. It's satisfying to see, isn't it? The satisfying amount of damage. I mean, more satisfying if it died instantly. I find with strong magic, it's the most satisfying thing in this game. Casting one spell and seeing the minion die in one of the larger special effects, more so than any physical attack. It's also pretty satisfying if you just use the regular tier 1 magic. That's also pretty satisfying. Yeah, so we'll take on this. Hopefully it's one minion. Might be 2 though. Yeah, pack drag. So we'll get that Sprecata, which is now levels 12 to level 13. So I'll have this one use one spell, then switch to that one. I think level 14 is when you, or not when you, when I'll have enough mana on this Sprecata. To get 3 hits in on Tauros. It gained 4 mana there. Maybe it won't. Maybe it'll be like one short. We'll let this one take down this. Pat drag. No 8 there. I think as far as the higher level magic, I think water and air, I think, have my favorite animations. There's something just so satisfying about the water animation. Maybe it's the sound. But I find it wonderful to listen to. I really enjoy it. So if we do this, we go up here and then back. I think that switches the end. Yeah, no, it doesn't. Okay, there's a swap. So for efficiency, I mean, I think that means it did switch the element. We'll kill this with our level 11. Get that one to level 12. Sorry, level 11 as well. No, yeah, we'll get a level 11. If we use either of our other ones, the swap will die in one shot. But it will be anywhere near as efficient for EXP gain for them to kill it. So now that we switched elements again. Actually, no, we didn't switch elements, did we? So this should still be a pat drag, right? If that was an elemental switch, then I'd go up to get the pat mantis. So we'll take on this. see how the level 13 handles it. That's about what I expected. Right, so we just need one more kill for that one, and then it is done leveling, can use its mana to help the others level, if need be. Actually, now the element is switched. I'm just not sure which screen transition really triggers the element switch. I don't know if it's controlled there. Back to fire again. I think it's going into this room. But coming from the other side didn't seem to do that, so I don't know. But if we ever see a wind one and Padrex in the room that we're in right now, we'll switch to fighting Patamantes instead. Okay, that's one level 14. This is just what you do if you get stuck against a turret. This is a very standard thing to do. Oh, that's one mana short from having three attacks against the turret. That's kind of sad. I just have to accept that. Every level counts. There aren't that very many levels in this game. The power difference between each level is fairly substantial. So it's worth getting these couple extra levels on. See that that level 14 Dracata has a 40 more health, which could mean the difference between an extra attack or not. I apologize for this fairly dull grinding against the same minion, but it's gotta be done. It was such goofy faces, Patrex. Now, if you haven't noticed already, look at their eyes. Look at their eyes the next time it's my turn against one. You see exactly what I mean. It's so funny. I'd like to think the designers were laughing when they made that. While you may call it disrespectful to the minion, you can't deny that as a goofy looking minion. Why is it permanently looking up? It doesn't even look forward. His eyes aren't facing the same direction. I guess that level 13 won't be leveling up yet, doesn't have enough mana to attack. Well, it certainly distracts me, but I don't know if it's that effective as a tactic generally. Okay, nearly done. Nearly done. I bought the standard 4 sleep spores, but I guess we will use them. We won't use all of them. We don't need all of them. Those guys only have enough mana for one each, so we'll use this one. Flying minions stay afloat when they stop. When they go to cast a spell, they aren't flapping their wings anymore. So how are they still flying? I mean, they're magical, so I guess it's that. That always struck me as a little bit odd. I think if you merge one extra, if we caught 6 instead of 3 Strikatas, we would have 3 magic attacks on each one, but I don't think it's necessary. So yeah, we can just use this one now, it has enough mana. So hopefully, and it ought to be, 6 Balias should be enough to take down Tatoris. Surely 6 of them is enough. Yeah, maybe I'm just not good at the whole suspension of disbelief thing. I see minion that needs to flap its wings to stay in the air, stop flapping its wings and not smack into the ground. Unless it's just flapping its wings for style points, in which case, fair enough, I respect it. I respect the commitment to the bit, if that's what it's doing. I will use a sleep spore here so I can do slightly fewer fights. Thank you. I don't think I've done a Tricata only fight versus the tourist since I was a very small child. When you're young, dumb, and fuse whatever into anything, you don't know. And you don't know how the system works. So you end up with absolute trash. Please let me run. Thank you. We will heal up the mana of one of our Strikatas. I don't think there's much of a point restoring the mana on the other. Because they can only get two attacks in anyway, so they just need enough mana to do two. And that's fine. We'll start with the one with the fewest mana. Sorry, the least mana. I'm good at grammar. Don't question me. Now, it does occur to me that when we go to capture the Hirasags in the next forest, that our air minions are woefully underleveled. But we will have to use them anyway. Okay, so we'll... Standard fighting procedure for this. We'll Devers mirror the first one. Just in case the tourist wants to be mean to us. Of the bendy leg man. The other ones don't have bendy legs. I always thought... Well, to be fair, then again, I remember them as the long nose guys, and only two of them have long... Like, notably, really long noses. Now that's painful. Oh, we have enough mana anyway. Never mind. Free attack. You're only gonna get two attacks in anyway, Tatoris. You played yourself. These guys are actually really good against Tatoris. When you say they were your least favourite, though, is that because of how they looked or because of their minion? Because hating Tatoris is very valid. So good. It's a shame we won't be using these anymore beyond this point. I don't even think we needed three. Again, I think we could have just done this with two. In all honesty. Yeah, that's the, low magic resist, magic defense coming into play. For the role it was in your team. Yeah, I mean... Yeah, that's fair enough. They are all pretty damn scary. / freaky. Especially, like, to a child, especially. To an adult, they're fine. There we go. Yeah, I could have done that with two. Switched off on heal one. I didn't need to do it with three, but playing it safe is absolutely valid. In other good news, though, we're almost done with making minions slash catching minions for the run. I know we're nearly at the end of the run as well, but it's always nice to know you don't need to catch anything new. Or it's always nice to know when you can not capture anything new, since it takes so much time. So we're going back here now to switch out the Dracartas. They are no longer going to be used. So we did a lot of fights that we didn't need to do. But I know that now for future reference, that two Dracartas is enough to take down Tartarus quite comfortably. Right. Let's grab the old crew. In there. Okay. So we have Dracartas all up here. Actually, is all there. Want everything nice and orderly. So we only need to capture three minions. Maybe four. And we don't need to use our minions to kill any minions, we're just going to capture some. Alright. We need to capture two of these guys. They have the highest combination of magic attack and speed in the game. They do, however, have no defense. And aren't very, Well, I say they have no physical... They have no defense at all, really. Physical or magic, they just don't have defense. Okay, it's asleep. For some reason, magic sleep sometimes doesn't play the animation of the minion that's asleep, but physical sleep always does. It's a bit of a weird quirk, I don't know why that is. Because, you know, sleeping is sleeping, right, as a status condition. So this is possibly a bit high in terms of health to capture this thing, that's why I put it to sleep. Increases your capture odds. Idea being, a minion that's asleep can't resist as much. At least I found that, in my personal experience, I found that putting them to sleep does help. So, let's summon the same one again. And just do the same thing. Use drain mana on me. Don't often see them use that attack. And yes, while we will have drain mana, we aren't going to be able to use it because it's a physical attack. Which is a bit sad, because drain mana on... Well, drain mana on magic minions is actually a bit daft, because they can't drain enough mana to use use it. You want drain mana on a physical minion. Okay. The easiest way to switch elements is to just leave and come back. We're also going to be slightly inefficient. We're now going to use all of those Shulias we caught earlier. Their time has finally come. So, we want to grab our Hero Sags, our 40 speed. You'd love to see it, 40 speed. It will cost a bit to do this initial merge, but we'll get it back later, hopefully. Maybe not, but it will give us more magic sack. And this is the best way I could think of to get. Yeah, to get a pure wind minion for the end game, which is still decent in terms of damage output. This is, of course, costing all of their health. So these guys are not going to live very long. 41 magic damage, that's very nice. And of course, these guys will look absolutely hideous. Show emergent minions? No. So now we just need to get the Amasag, which is the same minion but water. So back in we go. And that will switch the elements again, so now it should be Amasags that are in the forest. We're not going to use the minions we just mazed to attack this Amasag. It will die instantly. So we're going to use the, Actually, no, wait, we can use the Hero Sags, because they're not Earth anymore, of course. I don't know if this will kill it in one shot. Should we find out? I hope it doesn't, but it hasn't. Oh my god, what is that? What have we made? Oh my god! Oh no! That's gonna haunt my dreams now forever. forget about the bosses haunting my dreams as a kid. That's gonna haunt my dreams now. Oh, that thing's escaping. Oh, never mind. That was horrifying. I can only apologize for subjecting you to that. Well, let's go find one more of them. Oh, looks like maybe having some internet trouble. Hopefully he'll come back. Sorry about that, I just had internet troubles. Anyway. Hopefully this one gets captured neatly too. Okay, we're done capturing minions. Internet going down that was in the way. Alright, so now we're just gonna merge. We caught two Amasags, we're just gonna merge them together. We're not going to use the ids. It wouldn't actually necessarily be that bad of an idea to have used the ids, but Kashidra's very fast, and I'd rather have the highest possible damage output we can get. Sacrifice all survivability for damage. We don't need any of that surviving going on in our life. So, up to Amasags. Amasag plus Amasag equals better Amasag. Level does go up, which is sort of disguising the actual buffs that it does get, but there we go. And our last Mishkira will be replaced with our Amasag. And we are done. So based on how this run is gone, we didn't need to use three Cicadas, and we didn't need to use three of those Mishkiras / Squasp combinations. So we could have done it with just the two. All the way up till now. Now it would have been a bit cleaner. But it doesn't really make any difference. And yes, I suppose Flying Kermit is pretty apt for what they look like, but I'm still horrified. It's a solid 1 out of 10 for the good-looking minion contest. I may as well I'll just kill this with a Hirasag. I may as well. So, we now have a difficult, well not difficult as much as Not so much difficult as just more of a question. Do we prefer physical attacks or magic attacks from bosses? The bosses have lower magic attack, but we have very little defense. Just outright, we have very little defense. So, would we rather they use magic attacks that guarantee to hit us but do less damage, or would we rather they use physical attacks which almost certainly kill us, but we have fairly decent dodging odds? This is obviously a difficulty if we have bad dodges, then we'll have a problem if they use physical attacks. But we might have guaranteed problems if they only use magic. So do we need them to use physical attacks and to miss? That is the question at this point. I don't know how good Delphinel's odds are of hitting us with the speed stats that we have. I think it's the same base speed as Arpatron is what Heracykes have. And Amazykes. Maybe slightly better, I'm not sure. I think they both have 150 base speed. I suppose it's also the question of how quickly does the Earth boss die? Or at least Delphina. Not so much Earth boss overall, because we can use all three minions against Earth boss himself. It's just Delphina that we have to worry about. Let's see if walking makes this easier. Not sure on that one. I might be better at... I think I'm just better practiced at the running up, so I think that's right. That probably is. Don't know. It's very finicky either way. So we're going to do the safe thing here. We need to get our minions to be higher level. So we're going to go fight Earth Boss Ghosts, since that is the safe play. So one Earth Boss Ghost for each minion. Or at least, well, we only actually need to... I say for each minion, we actually only need the air ones to be significantly buffed. The water one's going to take down Earth Boss himself, which will buff that one up to level 21. So I guess we only need to get two to level 20. Let's see how much damage these guys do to... level 19 Earth boss here. Elemental advantage is not a thing against this guy, of course. Yeah, that's alright. That's not. We have no defense. What even is defense? We don't do that here. If I get an extra turn, I'm going to block. These guys fold up their faces when they block, and then, like, their lower jaw just goes down. It's very weird. Yeah, this is the scarier phase, as it were, because our minions have no defense. but you can't get a high defense minion really with the good magic at this point. A bit tricky. Oh my god. So, for comparison's sake, we have 227 health on that thing. When we had Petimals, they had 400 at level 20. We're gonna have maybe 250. So we really have no... We seriously have no health on our minions. Health is not a thing. So let's see how it does against a Tauren. Our level 19. Very high magic attack minion. Yeah, that's right. Will it be enough to take down Telfanel? I don't know. We also have to account how many extra turns we're going to get against Telfanel. That's the other thing that's going to be a little bit tricky. Because we have Maltia on our wind minions, which, in theory, benefits us. If we get to use all of our mana, then using Maltia is actually better. If we get to use all our mana. But if we don't, because we don't have enough health, then it does nothing for us. It's completely useless. So that is the question. If we get in a fight with the Spiral, by the way, we will level up our Water Amazak just for safety's sake. After seeing how much damage our low level minions take from Earth Boss, it'd actually be quite hard to outpace the damage without leveling it up at least a little bit. Be nice if we got this fight when they're both Earth Element. I think once we go into the ghost room and back, then it'll be the right element for it. Fighting Wind Boss, so we will have to Wrong Walk back in here every time. If we do die at any point. I don't like my odds beating Wind Boss with this setup. So we currently have 4 uses on that per minion. So that's why I like to see a block. We like block. That's why we got minion that's speedy. Extra 10. And we can't miss, which is always a bonus. Okay, so there's one more Earth Ghost Boss. We'll use that to get the one that just hit level 19 to level 20. We'll use regular enemies to get the current level 19 to level 20. we maybe fight one spiral to get our Amasag to level 18, which should be sufficient. So there should be now an Earth Tauren over here. Yeah, there is. And it should be a fight where there's two Earth minions, which are this level 19, our middle Hirasag, would appreciate. Sadly, we don't have Moltres. That would actually possibly help him. Where we'd hit both of them. Seems to be fine anyway, though. I don't know how fast Torrens are. Sorry about that. I don't know what that was. I think that was my controller. There it was. That was very loud, I apologize. Okay. Nearly done. I want to see how much damage Moltres actually does to these guys. So if it takes off more than half, then I don't need to be wasting mana. My minions regenerate about 25 mana per fight. Yeah, I can just use Moltres. So technically this way I regenerate more mana than I use. One more on that one. So, should be Spiral up here. It possibly has an escort. It does not. I think sometimes it just does, sometimes it doesn't. Now, Spirals, they are a bit of a problem for us because they are magically defensive and have high physical attack and high speed. So yeah, we have to hit it with three. Yeah, it does a bit too much damage to us. We need to... Well, it shouldn't get an extra turn on us, so we should be fine. But if it critical hits, then rip us. Yeah, if we was if this was a lower level minion, if it was level 14 maybe, then the spiral kills it. So it is good that we leveled it a little bit first on that Dougal. Alright, cool. Level 18. That should be enough to take down. Yeah, that should be enough to take down the Earth Ghost. Sorry, not the Earth Ghost. The Earth Boss. The actual Earth Boss. After we've taken down Delph now. So we just need to kill that. Oh, if we'll be permitted to leave. We'll have two goes at leaving, and if both fail, then we'll switch into a minion. Okay, cool. I'm kind of tempted to try the wind boss. I don't think we win. I think we still lose because we don't have elemental advantage against it. In fact, we have a strong speed advantage. I believe that minion's quite slow, and all of our minions are pretty fast. But if it hits us, it's just game over for us. Turn his turn, then two of our turns. And we kill him in two turns anyway, so. Never mind, immediately get the double turn. That kind of makes me want to try it against the actual Earth boss. Like, do we have just enough firepower to kill him before he summons his minion? We can try it, but it'll be I'll leave that up to you to decide. do we just try to kill him before he summons Delphinel? We may actually need the experience from killing Delphinel. Yeah, he's slow enough that you can just kill him before he summons Delphinel. It's also just like a matter of maths, right? If you have enough attack power, he can die. Yeah, to be fair, going for that strategy is actually going to be a part of next week's challenge run. We are going to try it. I don't think we'll succeed, but we are definitely going to try it because it'd be funny if it works. Oh my god, okay. Killing the gyro without elemental advantage, kind of tricky. Kind of hard. I also don't know if... I feel like putting it to sleep will not increase the amount of damage we do to it with magic. I'm going to switch to the water one now. May as well get it to level 19. To be fair, the Earth boss you actually fight, the proper one, is two levels higher than the ghosts. So it is quite a lot harder. I think if our minions were level 21 before we tried it, I think we have a good shot at it. But I don't think it's worth it. Oh, your wind. How are our minions looking? Little bit bruised. Well, mostly me who's bruised. Let's fix that. Got all this meta mugwort. I've been using it. Alright, that's, we don't actually care about the element once we do this wrong warp, so we're going to go into here and make it Earth. Fight it, kill it with our level 19 to get it to level 20. You know what, there's no point in us getting flesh to stone protection anyway. So we'll go for it. And if it works, it works, and if it doesn't, it doesn't. But normally the way you do it is you use Earth attack plus power, because Earth Elemental advantage in the arena. So Earth damage is boosted. Then you get, you're using like a Tur Grip or a Spiral based minion, and you get a critical hit, and that one shots him. So which one's our fastest minion? This one. But this one does slightly more damage. I don't know, I mean, we can try it. It'd be funny if it works, won't it? Let's try to get this wrong warp. We walked up to that, so let's see if... I think I'm facing the wrong way there. I am, yeah. I think that probably is easier to do. I was just facing the wrong way. Yeah, we'll see if it works. I'm willing to risk it. It's not like putting the Devil's Mirror onto our minion is going to help anyway. If we get hit by the Flesh to Stone attack, we're already... The minion's already gonna die from any damage source anyway. Though I do think our answer to the query I first raised when I got here is yes, we want them to use physical attacks. We have a chance to block those. We do not have a chance to block magic. Yashidra's gonna be scary. Yashidra's gonna be very scary. Does this thing die from multi now? Probably should do. Yeah, I was gonna say, if it didn't, I'd be very surprised. Level 20 versus level 13. Yeah, so we have like 150 less health than when we were using Potaimal. Very much so a fight against health versus damage. Our attacks will do more damage than the Potamos did. We have way less health. Should get another turn, yep. Yeah, Delphino shouldn't be the harder of the two fights because of his speed. His low speed should give us very good odds on blocks. Not perfect odds, but good odds. Whereas Kshidra is very fast, comparatively. We'll probably get some extra turns on Kshidra, but not as many. I wouldn't be surprised if like every other turn against Delphino was doubled. We are way faster than him. Ah. Maybe let's try walking in it, but I'm used to seeing how Levan looks as he runs into it. Oh, the angle's weird. That's probably right, but the angle's weird. Yeah, it was right. On Levan. I mean, we are definitely in the door. It might be facing the wrong way again. Okay, cool. Right, let's try walking this one in again. Because I want to see if we can use that to do this more consistently. I just need to make sure I'm facing the right way when I do the walking in. that right? I feel like it is, but I'm just gonna check. Here it is, okay. It doesn't look the same as it did because I'm not running, so. Bit tricky to control it on the analog stick. I want to be at like this angle. Maybe? It might be a bit early. Actually, it is early. Okay, maybe I'm not any more consistent to that one that way. It'd been nice if we were, but we just aren't. I'm a sag. We can probably still one-shot that. Due to their lack of magic, well, lack of any defense. I say as if they lack magic defense. They lack defense. I do think you can actually dodge these guys. I think you dodge them in much the same way that you dodge Mardrag. But in the regular one, you're using sleep spores to dodge an encounter with the Amisag, which is harder to escape from. So it makes sense to still use the sleep spores. I think it's overall faster to use them. It'd been nice if I walk it in, I can do it consistently. But apparently not. That looks right, but I think it's a bit early. Like a couple pixels early. That's too early. Yeah, that was way too early. What is that? What am I doing? I was right. I looked so early. Hitbox is a little bit janky on this. If we fail the spider forest wrong up again, I think I actually do just see if we can take down Wind Boss. I don't think we can, but I think we try anyway. We won't get to we wouldn't get to kill Wind Boss before Wind Boss acts. I don't think we could one shot Wind Boss. It'd be funny if we did, but I don't think. Yes. That's a bit early. That's right, okay. Okay, okay. Okay. I think I know what I'm looking for. Was that it? There? No. Finally further ahead. That should be right, I feel. It's not. Okay. Okay, we're gonna see if we can kill Wind Boss. Just so we're doing something different, instead of me just banging my head on that. Take a break from the wrong warp, see if you can. I don't know if we can. I don't like our odds given. Given our, minions' dispositions. As well, use some Seize Force. You don't really need them at this point. I see the internet struggling again. I would appreciate it if my internet would not fail on me, as it is viable to do. I have got to get a better internet if I wanted to. If I ever wanted to stream an online game, I would need to get better internet. This is way too unreliable. The consistency is terrible. Go through a door we didn't open. I don't think we even win this fight. I just want to see if we can. I just think it'll be funny if we can. Alright, let's see. Let's see what happens. Wind Elemental Arena buff. So, maybe? I honestly, I'd be shocked if this killed him, but it would be really funny, wouldn't it? Oh my god! Oh no! Oh, if we had like one more level. Just one more level. Oh, that can't miss, that's bad. Oh, if we had one more level. That's definitely doable. That is 100% doable. Okay, there goes one. It got hit by a physical attack, so it died. Because that's how that works. It so nearly did it. It's a shame. Crying shame. Alright, Saterian. Oh, okay, I see. Saterian has chosen death. By not risking the melee attack, it has died. Okay, I grossly overestimated how dangerous that boss was to our magic minions. Oh, if we... If we'd gone wind boss in one shot, I mean, if we'd gotten the I mean, now we have to heal our minions in exchange for our hubris. However, at the same time, Have we gotten one more level on our minion? Taking him out instantly, that would have been so funny. I'd love to take out a boss entirely without having to fight it in this run. I mean, you kind of skipped wind boss anyway, so that's not really bad. But if we manage to do it on Delphinel. Because there's no reason not to go for... Well, okay, there is a reason not to go for it. We would get another level 21 minion, which would help with Kshidra. But, think of how funny it'd be. If only it saved time in the any percent run to go for the... Earth boss insta-kill. Like, if we'd taken, like, a spiral back, modified it to have wind attack plus power, and then did that, got it to level 20 and then did that, that 100% kills him. That definitely instantly kills the boss. Unfortunately, our internet was down for that. So that's something that will have to be caught on replay. Yeah, if people want to see that, they'll have to catch that on replay, unfortunately. Alright. Do the wrong warp. Please. Please get it right one time. I don't know when I became so bad at this wrong warp. Specifically in the dark. In the dark. Spider Forest. Specifically. Not in the regular. Okay, so that's good. Hopefully my internet will come online again. I should have used sleep spores, but I forgot to. We got blocked in, we had to take a time. It's fine. We'll just kill them. We have more than enough healing items, and we aren't trying to go fast, we'll just kill them. The Humboots have, weirdly, they actually have like the lowest stat total in the game. They're actually very good because they're high speed, very high speed, very high attack. But they have the worst defense in the game. Like, their defensive stats are the worst. And they have no magic what to speak of either. They don't really need it. The problem is that they have no mana as a consequence. Don't get any mana. I should have used the stronger version. Okay, it didn't matter. Yeah, we'll heal up our minions. I'm just gonna check to see if my internet can come back. Nah, looks like it's not about to come back. Unfortunately, happens sometimes. There's not really anything I can do about it now. If I stop the stream or whatever, it ends up just logging it as a separate stream rather than a continuation of the same one, which is kind of annoying. I would really like it to come back, just in case we get the, I forgot about this, you can sometimes get a three-way fight on this screen, which is terrifying. I think the thing on the map has to be a Tehambu. And then you get the, I forgot to heal. Well, I ran twice, it's fine. Probably. It's definitely not fine. How much damage did that? Oh, it's definitely not on full health. Well, we're gonna switch into it, so I guess we can switch to Levant and then heal it. We have a Tendai. So it doesn't matter if one of our minions dies. Unfortunately, Deathless Run is impossible because we did have a death already against Wind Boss. Yeah, the internet doesn't look like it's going to come back up anytime soon. Ah, it is a shame. If we do get the instant kill on the Earth boss, then that's gonna be very funny from my perspective, but very sad that no one else gets to see it. Oh, they're basically full health. They're basically full health. It's fine. All right, let's see it. Let's see if we can get it. I don't think we can, but if we do. That's one. Ah, no, he summons Delphinel. Too fast. Too fast. Alright, Delphinel. Show me what you got. Preferably not very much. Oh, he knows the strat. Use the actually no, the strat is not to use Earth's magic. He doesn't know the strat. Please do that some more. If I get an extra turn, I think I use regular magic now. Get three of those in. Yeah, that's fine. Delphinel, you fool! You fool, Delphinel! Double turn? Okay, that was a bit hopeful of me. A little bit overly hopeful. We will... I have faith that we'll get a turn to block. Never mind, it did not matter at all. Okay, we're going to switch to the water one to finish off Earth Boss. Aw man, if we didn't go back to fight Wind Boss, this would probably be a deathless run. I mean, that's a bit... Okay, that's calling it early on my part, ignore that. Kashid was definitely killing one of these guys. There is no way that Kishidra doesn't kill. At least, one of them. May as well use my Great Muggles now. Alright, let's go. I could have maybe got that middle Heresag to level 21, tried it. Maybe you get the double turn instantly. But I think the speed disparity you need is a bit too great. So nearly killed the Wind Boss though. Clipping into his shirt. High quality animation. Well, I don't know if that's the animation fault or just... Well, it's probably just the, what's it called? Culling? Or just the render order that causes that to happen. Resolution isn't amazing on this incredibly old game, and that probably causes issues when compared to the actual models themselves, which don't have all these, you know, pixel edges. Hello, Dream Man. I've brought my own hellish nightmares with me. I have Flying Kermit. And that is all I need to fill my nightmares. I don't need you anymore. Alright, so let's see how bad this fight is for us. Because I have so little faith in our ability to win. It all comes down to how much damage Kishidra does to our minions. Because I think when the element is wind and Kishidra hits us with a wind attack, I think that one-shots our minions. I think that is sufficient to one-shot our minions. Okay, sick. Sick. We needed that, we need those. We very badly need those. It's very important that we have them. Okay, Okay, we got three hits on Kshidra without Kshidra hitting us yet. We don't do a lot of damage when we share an element. That was probably the best we could get there. Physical attack probably does kill, or nearly kills. Maybe we do prefer the physical attacks. Pretty hard to say, isn't it? I don't know. We definitely... Okay, this one's dead. Two magic attacks and we die 100%. No chance of survival. I think we Tendai that one now. I don't want to switch in another air one for it to die. I want Kshidra to switch to fire first, yeah. It was a safe turn to use the Tendai on, so I wanted to do that. I have another Tendai. So if I get another safe revival turn, we'll use that as well. This is the not nightmarish Amasag. How well can it live? We don't like that. Actually, no, we... Oh, no, yeah, because it's Fireman. But fine. We don't like that when Kshidra's... Oh my god, the laser will kill us. Never mind. Kshidra's never... Ooh, Kshidra dead in fire. That's pretty good. I'll take that. That's tasty, that is. I mean, if Kshidra switched to water, that would have been fine as well. Maybe I should have waited to switch to... Oh my god. Let's let everyone participate. Everyone gets to participate. No one gets left out. Nice flying Kermit. Okay, one more attack and it's time because it's guaranteed to hit. It cannot miss. Hours 23:56. Big shame that our internet died at the end. I think it's almost inevitable that my internet dies when I do very long runs. Like, it survives for about two... It can do about 2 to 3 hours, and then after that it just dies, it seems. But we have done it. We have beaten the game only using magic attacks, and we did it very inefficiently in a number of places. But we did manage it. So I did think this was possible. I thought it'd be a bit trickier because of how little health our minions would have. But I was proven very incorrect by the performance of our minions. Our mergers were, of course, very important. Which minions we merged in when mattered a lot. But that was actually pretty clean. Well, sorry. My performance wasn't clean. Absolutely, that was a very messy performance on my part. What was clean was the fights with our minions. Those were clean. Probably because we couldn't miss. Magic can't miss, and that's... I do enjoy the fact that we can't miss. Well, it was a very fast Kshidra. I still think it's slower than if you if you're just doing a regular playthrough. And you can make strong minions yourself. It's still almost definitely better to just use your own minions with elemental attacks. Sort of like what we did with the no elemental run, except give them an elemental attack and you do way more damage than we were doing. Like, way more. It should have been incredibly easy if that was the case. So yes, flying Kermit, nightmare horror thing. Very worthwhile. It was definitely the correct move to pick up those Shillias. Absolutely. I'm a bit sad that we didn't didn't kill Earth Boss before Delphinel came out, but I don't think we could have, really. Not without overleveling a little bit more to make that speed disparity come back. And if we gained one more level, maybe. Not for sure, but maybe we would have killed the air boss in one shot as well. And that would have been sick.
The power of light and darkness shall usher in the time of gathering. Kumari and Kaya, the guardian deities of light and darkness, shall be released by the twin dragons of Kemuel. The chosen ones of light and darkness shall meet, and only then will the accursed ones be granted repose, and man shall obtain yet another fruit of knowledge. But it shall bear the seeds of responsibility.
Nice relaxing credits. Alright. So next week is a much harder challenge. In my mind, way harder. This was tricky in terms of knowing the route to take. Obviously I was very inefficient with what I was doing because I didn't know what kind of power levels we could expect from magic attacks or magic minions. They proved themselves very capable. Obviously standard to like magic against the Taurus is very standard, I think. In terms of if you get stuck or don't have water minions. Just capture two of those, use those. Obviously I used three, which I did not need to do in order to save loads of fights. But if I ever have a silly challenge again where I need to use those guys, I will. Same with two squasps merged with I can't remember their names anymore. Rishans? I think. Sleeping birds is enough to take down Ocha. That's probably not going to come up again, if I'm honest. So next week is beat the game, but our minions can't level up. Specifically, what that means is if our minion levels up, we aren't gonna. The run doesn't end if our minion levels up, but we have to spin the minion, and we aren't allowed to use it in any more fights. If we ever see the level up screen for that minion, so that's what that challenge is. We'll see if we can do it. It does mean we're going to have to fight the final boss with level 18s, which is a little bit terrifying. But we will otherwise have free reign of merging. So it's more of just a level limit of 18 from spirals. That's the highest level we can get. And we won't be able to use any low-level minions as late game bases, because they won't be high enough level. We can't use Amadro, we can't use Arbitron as a base, because they're too low level. And we're going to see if we can get through the game doing that. So, thank you guys for watching. Hope to see you all around next week again, for our next challenge run and more Any% speedruns as usual, on Tuesday and Wednesday, as I've been doing for the last few weeks. And, yeah, that was actually pretty good. I did not expect the magic minions to do anywhere near like that, as well as that did. Sorry, my words are all over the place, I'm tired now. I didn't expect that to go anywhere near as well as it did. There we go, I can speak English. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I hope that you don't see the horrible Kermit nightmare in your dreams, as I most assuredly will.